10 cats.
Big Pimpin', it's Tim Westwood. All together now, it's David O'Doherty. And their team captain, Sean Unlock. And facing them tonight, this DJ saved my life. It's Lauren Laverne. Stand up, it's Matthew Crosby. And their team captain, John Richardson. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Uncut, a show about opinion polls, surveys and statistics. Did you know, for example, 85% of men are happy to cry in front of other people? If they're happy, why are they crying? It takes a woman 3 minutes to decide whether she'd sleep with a man, whereas it takes a man 3 seconds. Boobs, no Adam's apple, own teeth, I'll do it. Yeah. The big dog agrees, yeah. And 57% of Brits don't know their grandparents' full names. I do. It's Granny No Legs and Granny Prison. Right, let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. Tonight, as schools have just broken up, it's our panellists' job to guess the British public's top five most memorable things about school. Sean's team. What do you think are the most memorable things about school?
Teachers, because they teach at the school.
Teachers, best teacher?
I don't know, it's too long ago. I went to school in black and white.
We've got a bit of an advantage. I don't want to say we're cheating, but Matthew here actually went to school.
And still has the uniform.
I've come dressed in, yeah. No, I was a teacher for about 4 years, and like one instance sticks in my mind. I'd only been teaching for probably about 2 or 3 months, and a girl I was teaching, she was 15 years old, she came to me and she said, me and my boyfriend are going to have a baby. And that's just horrible, because it's my boyfriend and I are going to have a baby.
I mean, what did you teach?
I taught English and then drama and media studies, but everyone taught that.
Is that like a relegation from English?
Yeah, yeah. You're a shit English teacher. Yeah. I'm afraid you're on media studies now. That's the way it goes. You're just about good enough to put on a DVD and go to sleep, which is pretty much all media studies was. Watch Star Wars. We might talk about it afterwards. We probably won't.
That was the best thing when they like wheel in the big telly. Did anyone else have those? The telly with the massive legs. And you go like video day, brilliant. And then you'd watch something really shit. But it was great.
No one knew how to use it either. No. That was like, as soon as I became a teacher, I've lost the ability to use a TV or VCR or any of that. Just like, doesn't make any sense to me. I'm sure I could do this at home, but just do I press the screen? Is the screen? I've got no idea what's going on.
I think I could teach at primary school, because I think at primary school you could just make it up. If they kind of go, why, you just go, well, monster said.
I knew someone in a band who was a supply teacher and had to leave because he kept going into the classes and telling the class that they'd go, where's Miss? And he'd go, oh, she's dead. He did it about 10 times and got the sack.
I wrote a children's book about 10 years ago and did some readings for school groups. And the greatest ever heckle in the history of entertainment was at a reading for a school group one day. A guy who was about 6 just put up his hand and he said, excuse me, does this get good soon?
The worst teachers are the ones that try and sort of banter and be your
mate. The cool kind of ones that try and be
your mate. Teacher, just everything you've said, he would sort of try and make it sound like, so if you go, oh, sir, can I do some photocopy? And you go, I'll photocopy you.
I mean, one teacher threatened me.
Threatened you?
Yeah. Told me, get out of the class, go and stand outside the headmaster's office. And he was still so annoyed, he left the class, came down the stairs. Well, I was standing outside the headmaster's office. Big bloke, played rugby. And when it came right to me, he goes, I don't care, look. He said, if I lose my job, he said, but one more word from you, and I'm going to punch you in the face. He knew he'd lose his job. I'd made him that angry. And all I'd done is just ask stupid question after stupid question.
We had a teacher, and the way... Well, the only time he ever really lost it was the bold boys had a thing called a boobs bomb, which was to annoy one teacher where you'd... So you'd steal page 3 from the newspaper, and then you'd get wet toilet paper and wrap it sort of boobs up like this. Oh, yeah, you'd stick drawing pins through it, and then because there were ceiling tiles, you'd get it and you'd go whoop, and it would stick up onto the ceiling tiles, and then during the class, the water would evaporate out of the toilet paper and some physics process would take place whereby the teacher in the middle of the class would be sitting there and boobs would go shunk down. And we'd go, sir, are you looking at boobs? Ah!
Did you have any good teachers, Tim?
I didn't enjoy it, mate. It was like, I was dyslexic and they, like, I didn't really do well.
Were you dyslexic? Were you just old-fashioned stupid? Be honest.
Old school stupid.
Old school, yeah.
What used to happen, I was the only kid, my school was like 2,000 kids, I was the only kid who didn't do any, like, French or German, so they used to put me in this pottery room, but those bastards never gave me no clay.
In the pottery room with no clay.
And is that where your idea was then? You just one day just put a record down on the potter's wheel.
Exactly. Yeah.
It all started. Well, let's see if teachers are one of the most memorable things about school. Of course. Yes, teachers. Secondary school teachers need a degree, while primary school teachers must be able to speak in a patronising voice and pretend to be interested in shitty pictures. Over to John. What else do people remember about school?
You know, school dinners I quite liked. So I remember I have lots. Yeah, I liked.
You liked school dinners?
Yeah, it's just nice to get a hot meal and sit with your mates. And because.
That's the.
If you'd like to make a donation.
Yeah.
You look back though, like a kid with a packed lunch is quite cute. Adult with a packed lunch. Losers!
That's weird. When did that happen? At what age does a packed lunch become creepy?
I quite like a packed lunch.
Creepy. I just eat my thing with you. So, school dinners. Did you get school dinners?
Yeah, we used to love school dinners. We used to like getting served by the dinner lady with a massive rack.
Back of them.
I used to love it. It was a highlight of my day.
A friend of mine shagged a dinner lady. Right in my school. Shagged one of the dinner ladies. He was about 16. And we said, Christopher, what do you mean? He goes, yeah, I've been shagging the dinner lady. He said, last week she took me on a narrow boat. She took him away on a narrow boat. And I was just shagging him on this narrow boat. And he said, and she's taken some Polaroids, because we're talking in the olden days. Polaroids is the only way you'd get photos of that description printed. And there was a picture of her with her top off, right, and in foam. Right, she'd written a big C for Chris in shaving foam over her tits.
That's my favourite story there's ever been. The dinner ladies on my school wouldn't have got onto a narrow boat because of physics. The dinner ladies at my school were not, how can I put this, they were not DILFs.
Yeah.
I fancied one of my dinner ladies. This was like primary school when you don't really know what the deal is, but I just...
You didn't know she was out of your league. I want to make a play for this lady.
I used to cycle to near her house and just stare at her house. I had, like, a viewing point where I would just sit and watch.
Sorry, how old were you when this happened? Because if you were 6, this is cute. No. If you were 18, you're going to jail.
You make Morrissey sound like zippity-doo-dah.
You know what I think the most depressing thing about that? You, outside the dinner lady's house, on your bike, age 10, thinking, I really like her, and then seeing Sean's mate coming out, he's just bang. I can tell you that school dinners is not one of the most memorable things about school. It's vital that Britain's 14-year-olds eat well, because a healthy diet is incredibly important when you're pregnant. Sean's team. What else do you think people remember from school?
I remember exams. I once wrote the equation for quadratics on my wanger.
on your what, sorry?
It's Irish for book.
Like, it's the state exams when you're 15. The person would follow you and stand outside the loo so you couldn't cheat, but they obviously wouldn't go into the... They wouldn't, like, stare at you while you were at the urinal. So I wrote minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a on my actual pipe.
when I was at school, they had these qualifications called CSEs. So they don't really have anymore, and I got a few CSEs. And they're the most pointless qualification ever, because about 2 years after I got them, they just disbanded them. They no longer did them, which basically made them like money that's no longer legal tender. Like if you went for a job and you say, I've got a couple of CSEs, they go, well, the government's acknowledged they're worthless. Having a CSE was equivalent to having a sticker saying, Sean, done some maths.
There's a thing in this country where it's really cool to not try and to, like, come out of exams and go, yeah, I didn't even revise and I did it in 20 minutes. It used to really piss me off. As people used to turn up to exams with one pen. I used to think, what are you going to do? And they were like, they put their hand up and they went, can I have a pen? Because mine's run out. They should have said, no, lesson learned.
Did you have the lucky mascot?
No, just took preparation and revision.
In between bouts of staring at a dinner lady's house.
Matt, did you pass your exams? Presumably, you became a teacher.
Yeah, well, not only passed them, I ended up invigilating exams as well, which we have to stand in a room with loads of kids and just make sure they don't cheat and, you know, all that kind of stuff. But we used to play a game where myself and the other invigilator would say, all right, we have to stand by the kid that we think is definitely a virgin. So we sort of...
So you would stand next to the kid you thought was definitely a virgin.
Yep. And then they would stand and we'd just look at each other and go.
Is there a variation on this? So who else would you stand next to? What are the variations on the game?
Who's got the unhappiest home life? Who's got the weirdest voice?
Unhappiest home life? Oh no.
Jimmy.
That is cold.
Jimmy, you've got to understand.
I think that's cold and I'm me.
Yeah.
Let's have a look and see if exams are one of the most memorable things about school. Yes, indeed, exams. I got an A in history, a B in chemistry, and an STD in games. John Steen, what do you think's up there?
What would you say you remember the most?
Well, from being at school, it was the waking nightmare of PE lessons. I'm shaking just thinking about it. I mean, this is a show that requires you, just to put it in context, it requires you to sit down and talk, and I've brought my inhaler. So you can tell... You can tell the kind of person I was in PE lessons. It was a genuine nightmare.
Were you any good at PE?
I quite liked PE. The only bit of PE I hated was swimming, because I've always thought, since we evolved from the sea onto the land, if you're a good swimmer, it just means you haven't fully evolved. Quite proud to be crap at swimming, but no, I liked it. I'd rather be outdoors running about and kicking a thing than...
Well, that's the weird thing. If I was going to put a bet on whether John was in the sporty or the nerdy camp,
yeah.
I would have gone nerdy camp straight away. Not nerdy camp, obviously, that's a different thing.
But, oh, have you read Harry Potter?
Yeah.
To die for.
Well, I would have definitely, if I had to guess, I would have said you were in the nerds. But what you did was you stepped... You could have been top of the nerds, but you went to bottom of the jocks. You took that tiny little step up.
I was never
jock bottom.
Seen.
Jock
never.
Bottom, exactly. You don't want to be jock bottom.
I had jock bottom once, and it really is itchy. David, you're a pretty sporty guy. I happen to know you're under-14 high jump champion for...
No. Under-14 East Leinster triple jump bronze medalist.
I'm this close.
I don't want to turn it into a dust down so early, but I was actually Her Majesty's Northern School's silver medalist.
Ooh.
No. Ooh. I mean, I'll take you on a triple jump if that... No, I don't mean here. That's ridiculous. You name the time, name the place.
Tomorrow, the sandpit.
I did all sports because I preferred it to sitting indoors, and I broke... a bone every year from when I was 7 to when I was 18, and my school was beside a hospital, and a priest, because it was a priesty school, used to take me over to the hospital, and I would get x-rayed on average about once every 2 weeks. So I am either completely sterile or my children will have incredible superpowers.
we had a chest in our school with some PE equipment in it. You know, if you weren't particularly skilled at the basics, which is football and running about. And they had... This shows how badly equipped the school was. They said, oh, you can do fencing at this school. Said, oh, right. So you go into this box, and they've got two swords and one mask. Someone's losing an eye. They never got
you. No, but that is motivation to get good, isn't it?
Tim, were you a sporty type?
No, that wasn't my thing at all, to be honest.
No?
Like, quite often we'd leave our kit behind, and they got hip to that, so they used to have, like, a lost property kit. So quite often, if you said you left your kit behind, you'd be doing PE in, like, a girl's skirt or some knickers.
They'd make the big dog do PE in girl's skirts.
I had a rough time as a kid.
Did you rebel? Did you no, pop a cap in anyone's ass?
I wish I had at that time.
Yeah. I remember at my school, I forgot my kit or whatever. I didn't want to do it exactly. 1 week. I said, I'm not doing games. Exactly. And as a punishment, they made me go and watch the girls do trampolining. In the history of ineffective punishments, it's right up there. It was awesome.
I have a friend who's called Shorty to this day, and people presume it's because he's tall, but it's because at another friend's sixth birthday party, he weed himself, and then because my friend's trousers wouldn't fit him, he had to wear a pair of shorts. And 25 years later, he's still called Shorty.
I've got a sort of an opposite. There was a kid in our class who was called Diarrhea Dave. And everyone thinks it's because he had like a little accident in class. And it wasn't. He was the only kid in the whole school who could spell it.
Lots and lots of my family are teachers. And my auntie, who's a brilliant teacher, reckons that you can tell how good a school is or how, you know, how good fun, like, and how cool the pupils are by the nickname that they give the teachers.
All right, go on.
There was one at a school she worked at where there was a really kind of dictatorial teacher with a big chin, and the kids nicknamed him Chin Laden, which was just kind of...
That is good.
It was good.
It is. It's funny the way people find the truth about you through your nickname. Because my nickname in school was Mr. Fully Awesome Legend.
But anyone who says their nickname is lying. Everybody's nicknames are offensive, right?
I mean, in PE, I was like, oh, it's just like the bullying. Like everyone, like, you'd come into the showers and everyone calling me donkey and tripod and stuff. just leave me alone, right? I'm just trying to do games like a normal person. I'm getting out of here. Let's have a look and see if PE is one of the most memorable things about school. Oh. Yes, PE lessons. If we forgot our gym kit at school, our gym teacher used to force us to do it in our pants, which used to make him do something in his pants. OK, fingers on buzzers. Two more to go.
I always liked, basically, I was sort of school trips. I always thought the weirdest thing about school trips is that if, like, a 50-year-old man in a tweed jacket walks through a wood with one kid, the police get called. But if he's got about 50, no-one does anything. But I think teachers got enough credit for, like, take... Cos I remember, you never thanked the teacher. The bus driver certainly never got thanked. He was just, this is Brian, he's driving the bus. Dickhead!
At least they were up the front of the bus driver, and the troublemakers were obviously always at the back of the bus with their arses out, pressed up against the back window.
The old geeky pants. Behind the yellow line. I just want to talk to you.
I only went on one school trip.
Where did you go?
Aylesbury. Because people were talking about it the other day, and I was thinking, we didn't go on any school trips. And there was just one to Aylesbury, and it was pissing with rain. And the teacher sort of said, that's really rainy out there. And we just had our packed lunches on the coach, dicked around a bit, and he said, this is just... He didn't say it's a waste of time, but basically he looked at it and said, this is a waste of time. And then we all went back.
Did you take kids on school trips?
Yeah, we went to Winter Wonderland. It was awful because it was all the kids saying, oh, come on, sir, you'll go on the roller coaster. And it's really embarrassing when the kids can go on the ride, but I'm too small. Oh, yeah, go on, year eight. On you go, everyone. But no, and I'll hang back here. Just don't look at the crocodile doing this and you'll...
They used to have to go and get drinks for you in the pub.
Buy us some fags, would you? Come on.
Tim, did you go on any school trips?
We used to go up to the swimming pool, like, on a Wednesday.
No play again. No play. They take the bloody water out, had they?
I don't know. I don't know if that's what we would call a school trip, but yeah, I mean, okay.
We were nine. We went on a school trip. Oh, God.
That is a great start to a story.
We went on the ferry to Holyhead from Dublin, and we went to a slate mine. In the slate mine, there was an exhibition about how children of our age used to work in the slate mine and die. And then we got back on the ferry with the truckers. And I went home. And I just remember, like, parents going, what happened to... Don't talk about it! You'll never know. You weren't there!
OK, let's see if school trips is one of the most memorable things about school. Yes, school trips! If you want to remember the dullest school trip you ever went on, just watch The One Show. Oh, look, Phil Tufnell at the Pencil Museum. OK, fingers on buzzers, one more to go.
Is it the holidays, when you used to have holidays? You used to look forward to the holidays. And then they'd have the holidays. It's great.
The holidays were, yeah, I mean, it was a lifetime.
Yes, it was wonderful. School's out for summer. School's out forever. School's been blown to pieces.
That is what
it feels a little bit Lord of the Flies. Who are we going to sacrifice? Him.
School holidays in Ireland were 12 or 13 weeks. So you'd break up last week of May, you come back first week of September, and people would just have children and beards and things. They're completely different people.
So I remember the thing in Ireland was I had a lot of Irish relatives, and it was the school holidays, but they said, oh, they're really long because that people need help with the harvest.
Yeah.
You go, wait, but you live in Dublin.
Yeah.
What are you harvesting?
Anecdotes.
Lawrence, school holidays. I imagine yours consisted of playing in bands, mainly.
It did, yeah. That was why I formed a band, because a band in the first place, because we were on holiday and we were bored, and we tried to learn to skateboard in the local Sainsbury's car park. We weren't very good at that.
We got told off. We used to ride bikes in Asda car park. We got told off by the man who collected the trolleys. So you're not allowed. We had a den at the top. We spent all summer building it. It was the best den
Brilliant.
Ever seen.
Yeah,
we had a toilet. We dug a pipe underground, so you peed in at the top and it came out on the cycle track. We had offices.
You had sanitation in your den. You were the most boring child there's ever been.
Go to the farting room. Want to break wind.
School holidays. Well, I imagine you were very well behaved in the school holidays. You maybe cruise in the lowrider.
Bit of pimping.
Pimping ain't easy, is it?
No, not so
People
fair.
Think it's easy, but it ain't easy.
It's a good way to earn a bit of money, you know. Tied you over this, you know, my parents used to say, you've got to go and get a job. That's what I remember school holidays, is just be repeatedly bullied into getting a job. Get out and get a job. I remember getting my CSE and O-level results. I was working...
CSE working, singular.
I was working in a... I was working in a flange factory.
They make them in factories.
And they used to make flanges for pipelines. They bullied me. I got a job, and I'd have put a flange into a machine and used to cut a groove in it with a gear cutter.
I'm not 100% sure I know what a flange is. But if it's what I think it is, that is disgusting.
When they join up pipelines, you need a flange. It's like a washer, but it goes in between them and it has like a rubber seal in it. So it's like a flange.
Oh, right. Let's see if school holidays are one of the most memorable things about school. So those were the most memorable things about school, but other things that didn't quite make our list. Well, sadly, a lot of bullying goes on in schools. There was a kid at our school who was always being bullied. Little weedy kid, didn't stand a chance. But then, one day, he decided he wasn't taking it anymore, and he went right up to them and he said, enough is enough. And I'll never forget what those bullies did. They smashed his fucking face in. So at the end of that round, Sean, David and Tim have 3 points. John, Lauren and Matthew have 2 points. That's it for part one. See you after the break. Welcome back to AR10 Cats Uncut. Our next round is Pick of the Polls. Sean, David, Tim, your turn first.
Well, I think we've got Tim here. We'll go for the gentleman who looks like he does a bit of rap.
OK, you've chosen the rapper. Here is a clip to illustrate your question.
Boys and girls, the Lord Jesus Christ is the one who gives us new life, and he's doing a new thing for us. Get always donut. God is doing a new thing.
There must be a video of John doing a very similar thing about 8 years old. I can really imagine you doing the Running Man.
I used to do a rap on a radio station I used to do at home called Rocket Radio. Pretty fly.
You know, they're doing a no thing.
Here is your related question, OK? Most people would rather be a rap star than Prime Minister. Do you think that's true or false?
True.
Absolutely true. Why
you think it's true? You want to be a rap star?
Why wouldn't you?
You might get shot, Tim.
I'm not a rap star and I got shot, so it happens.
You got capped, didn't you, brother?
Yeah.
That is, that's pretty whack, if you ask me. I mean...
That's how I felt about it.
So when you were...
No.
Doesn't hurt.
Where'd you get it?
Just in the arm.
Obviously, Tim Westwood, you would want to be a rap superstar, right?
All day.
All day?
Yeah, well, all the time, yes.
I like the idea that a rapper would stop at night. Yeah. I would bang another hole, but, early start in the morning.
I like a bit of rap. I don't know who it is. I like it, it's all right.
It's not all one guy, Sean.
This will surprise people, but I'm not a fan of rap.
Oh.
Yeah, really? I think they've basically taken music and just stopped doing the singing bit. We'll keep the backing, but we'll just talk.
I interviewed Cliff Richard and he said much the same thing.
Yeah.
You are at one on that.
That's another thing you've got in common with him.
People forget that Cliff Richard was pretty cool for a while.
David O'Doherty, would you rather be Prime Minister or rap superstar?
Well, I would make a terrible rap star. I am the least hip hop person that I know.
Make a bloody good umpire, though.
Ireland beat England in cricket recently and no one knows how to play it. You'd get like someone had like the man hit it into the stand and half the people in the pub I was watching it with were like, oh well that's rude. Is that good? Yes! Take that, 800 years.
So what do you think, Prime Minister or
I think
rap
people
star?
Would much rather be a rap star. If you're a rap star, you can put hose on expenses. Whereas you can't.
It's the same for rap stars and gardeners.
Okay, so you're all going rap star.
Yes, yes. I
okay,
think so,
what
yeah.
about over here?
I would say, no one wants to be prime minister, do they? So
well, not even the prime minister wants to be prime minister at the moment. I, you know, wouldn't imagine.
It's a lot of responsibility either way. Is there an option for neither?
There is, and you are living it.
I think we're going rap star, aren't we?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
I can tell you that it is false. Only 34% of people would rather be a rapper than Prime Minister. I mixed the two and become MP Diddy. So at the end of that round, Sean, David and Tim have 3 points. John, Lauren and Matthew have 2 points. That's it for part two. See you after the break. Welcome back to AI Thinkcats Uncut. And the winner is the name of our final round. Here's your first one. Top gadget that makes British people happy.
Is it Inspector Gadget?
It is not, but it should be. Top gadget. What makes you happy? What gadget has changed your life, John?
You're really asking the wrong guy in terms of, you know, most people. Generally, in my life, I would say the gadget that's blown my mind the most is the boiled egg slicer.
You press it and it...
It's like a little cradle and you just put the egg to bed and it says, all right, Mr. Egg, you're going to be... BOOM! I also got a pickled onion grabber.
Is it your hand? No. It's not a gadget.
It is for you, Mr. Vinegar Fingers.
No! Curse my vinegar fingers.
Just looks like a pen. You press it, little prongs come out like that. Pickled onion, madam. There we go.
The ladies must just swoon.
John's only problem is he's had to take it next door to someone to open the jar for him. Mr. Bronson, could you open my pickled onion jar? I've got some ladies coming round.
Dinner ladies. Top gadget, what do you think? What's the best gadget?
Well, it's got to be iPhone, hasn't it? Because that's got music on it. I always think if I could have gone back and told myself when I was 15 that you could carry an entire record collection that was also a phone and a computer, I would have just blown my fucking mind. In your back, like, it's this big. How is that even possible? It's just a daily miracle.
It is, yeah, it is basically, it's magic.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of stuff in my house that if it didn't exist, you could fashion it out of twigs.
Yeah.
The iPhone, good luck. As far as I'm concerned, it's made by pixies.
I don't have an iPhone, but I have an iPod. And sometimes I pretend that my iPod is an iPhone. I'm talking to someone who's really boring. I mean, I got it. Hello? And then I go, oh, look, it's Prince.
We're still happy with the telly, aren't we? That's still the best one.
No.
No?
No.
What's better? There's nothing better than
the phone.
Telly.
You can have the fucking telly on. Phone's got everything else as well.
No, it's going to be a laptop. It's going to be a laptop, definitely.
I like the iron because it keeps the missus quiet. She's happy and she's busy.
Headphones?
Headphones don't even make.
Is it a clog rack?
Is it a what?
Clog rack. Yeah. You know, you got all your clogs. Mine are just in... put all these clogs. And you go, shit, there's a clog rack. Great. And you go, oh, thank God. You know, it's nothing better than you've got all your clogs. From all the different colours, the rainbow, all lined up. Is it a clog rack?
No. I will give you a clue.
Couldn't live without that, baby.
You were pretty close with the TV, but it's better than normal TV.
Computer.
Oh, Sky Plus.
That's the right answer.
Oh my God, I never said that.
Of course. Yes, the top gadget that makes British people happy is Sky Plus. I know News International are accused of systematic criminality. They're morally retarded. They've descended from the gutter to the sewer. But seriously, SiriusLink has changed my life. Worst thing to do in a job interview?
I suggest any telling of the truth. The worst thing you can ever do. The whole thing's bullshit, isn't it? When they say, what are your weaknesses? You never actually say. You do not want to pick that scab, my
friend. That would be a great response. Imagine if that happened on the final episode of The Apprentice. Yeah. Weaknesses? Oh, well, how long you got? Have you ever had a proper job?
Never.
And I don't mean that in a bad way, but have you ever had a proper job?
Never had a proper job in my life.
Were you a DJ straight out of...
I had nothing else to do.
Compton.
Yes.
Compton. Reacting to everything as if it's an innuendo? That always pisses me off. What do you think you can bring to the job? That's what she said.
To turn up like dressed really inappropriately, like dressed in the just totally the opposite way to
like,
how you're supposed to.
As a Nazi. Oh, no. That would be the worst thing.
Yeah, that would be.
Well, not if you're going for a job at the palace.
It's a bad idea to refer to yourself throughout the interview as Lord Party Jet. Wear a cape.
Top hat as well. Top hat wouldn't be very good, would it?
But just a top hat and a cape.
And then you'd drawn a big mouth on your tummy. And you did that so it looked like it was top. Where'd you see yourself in 5 years' time? Sitting right where you are.
Worst thing to do at a job interview. It would upset the interviewer.
Was it ask them questions, be rude to them?
Be rude to them, that's the right answer, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are John, Lauren and Matthew have 3 points. Sean, David and Tim are the winners with 4 points. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.